हेलो फ्रेंड्स, आई एम डॉक्टर हर्षल कुलकर्णी। वेलकम टू दिस लाइव सेशन। टुडे वी विल बी टॉकिंग अबाउट हाउ टू प्रिपेयर स्ट्रैटेजी, व्हाट शुड बी बेसिक अप्रोच, हाउ टू क्रैक द मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट सब्जेक्ट एनवायरनमेंट एंड इकोलॉजी फॉर यूपीएससी सिविल सर्विसेज एग्जामिनेशन। डियर फ्रेंड्स, यूपीएससी गिव्स सिलेबस इन फॉलोइंग मैनर फॉर प्रीलिम एग्जामिनेशन: General issues on environmental ecology, biodiversity and climate change that do not require subject specialization. Dear friends, UPSC gives only three titles like environmental ecology, biodiversity and climate change. But this topic actually emerged as one of the most important topic for the prelims and main examination. This topic is definitely small, but its impact is vast. The importance of environment and ecology subject can be seen from the fact that it constitutes around 25 to 30% of the general studies paper 1. Skip this subject at your own risk. With the change in format since 2011, when this topic was specifically mentioned, the number of questions that are they can be allocated to this particular topic is actually very high. From 2011 to 2019, 18 to 20 questions were there from this section only. The reason for this is very simple. Indian Forest Services examination prelim process was introduced in that examination, and the prelim process is basically merged with the civil services examination. Let us take a review on previous year question analysis. Dear friends, from 2011 to 2019, environmental subject carries following questions: 2011, 21 questions, 1 question is equal to 2 marks, is equal to 21 questions, 2011, 42 marks, 2012, 23 questions, 2013, 22 questions, 2014, 31 questions, 2015, 23 questions, 2016, 17 questions, 2017, 14 questions, 2018, 9 questions, and 2019, 17 questions. On an average, 18 to 20 questions were there from this section. The weightage of environmental and ecology topic has gone up, and that is why this has become an important portion of the paper. We can basically see that the average number of questions were around 80 to 20 from this small topic or chapter is actually a very significant. So now we will try to identify that how and why you should study environment and ecology, so as to cover most of the things that you want to do for scoring 80 to 90% marks in the question from this section. Dear friends, environment and ecology subject is also included in mains paper number 4, is called general studies paper number 3. This subject is backbone of UPSC civil services examination. Let us take a look on main syllabus. Main syllabus included major crops, cropping pattern in India, different types of irrigation and irrigation system, transport and marketing of agricultural produce, issues and related constraint, e-technology in the aid of farmers, direct and indirect farm subsidies and related issues, minimum support prices and issues, economics of animal rearing, technology mission for various crops. In second topic, conservation, renewable and non-renewable resources, environmental pollution and degradation, environmental impact assessment. The third and most scoring subject or topic is biodiversity. In this, intellectual property right and disaster management are the most important topic included. First and foremost, you need to understand that environment and ecology is a subject which is combination of three different subjects, and they are independent too. An interdisciplinary approach that includes biology, ecology and geography. If we move further or discuss about it, we need to take syllabus as the benchmark. In syllabus, it is clearly mentioned environment and ecology, biodiversity and climate change. Let us take a detailed review and structure of environment and ecology topics related to pre and mains subject. Environment and ecology consist of ecology, components of environment, ecosystem, types of ecosystem, functions, energy flow, food chain, food web, ecological pyramids, biogeochemical cycle. It basically means the conceptual part of the ecology, and there are definition based question also. The next PPT shows food chain and ecological pyramid. Food chain and ecological pyramid. An ecological pyramid is three types, like pyramid of biomass, pyramid of number and pyramid of energy. We discuss or we study in detail in our online course. Next picture shows hydrological cycle, one of the biogeochemical cycle. Dear friends, in our detail course, we study different types of biogeochemical cycle, like hydrological cycle, nitrogen cycle, phosphorus cycle, sulfur cycle, carbon cycle. The PPT shows hydrological cycle. The next PPT shows major factors of ecosystem. Ecosystem consists of two major factors, is called biotic factor, living factor that influence an ecosystem, and abiotic factor, non-living factor that influence an ecosystem. Dear friends, next topic after environment and ecology topic, in environment and ecology topic, conceptual and definition based part is widely constituted. In second topic, pollution or environmental pollution, we are facing pollution on many level. Example, air pollution, which is evident, soil pollution, river and water pollution. In this topic, we study air pollution, smoke plus fog, fly ash and fly ash policy, indoor air pollution, water pollution, sound pollution, soil pollution, radioactive pollution, e-waste, solid waste, and environmental impact assessment. Environmental impact of the coal industry, smog, indoor air quality, volatile organic compound, suspended particulate matter, algal bloom, greenhouse gases, ozone hole, so that all types of pollution, its impact and what happening in the current scenario is covered in this environmental pollution topic. Next topic is biodiversity. In this chapter or topic, we study biodiversity conservation, types of conservation like in situ and ex situ conservation, world hotspot, red data book, IUCN classification, man-animal conflict, invasive alien species, insectivorous plants, medicinal plants, and all those anthropogenic changes basically causes disruption and damage to biodiversity. The next PPT or picture shows different difference between in situ and ex situ conservation. The PPT shows in situ conservation type like protected area network, like sacred groves, sacred lakes, and in ex situ conservation like botanical garden, zoo, aquaria, seed bank, or field gene banks or cryo preservation. Next PPT shows biodiversity in India from Jammu Kashmir to Kanyakumari. Conservation aspects, lots of damage has been caused by various anthropogenic factors to the environment, climate, agriculture, soils or entire system. So how and what we can do to conserve these things, and when we talk about conservation aspect, we not only consider flora, we also consider fauna. In this topic, we also study protected area network, wildlife sanctuary and national park, difference between wildlife sanctuary and national park, Conservation Reserve and Community Reserve, Sacred Groves of India, Man and Biosphere, Biosphere Reserve, World Heritage Site. So animal conservation or the plant conservation or the ecosystem conservation and every kind of conservation activities will come into picture. Let us take a review on conservation efforts. Indian government or state governments take different types of efforts to conserve animals and plants. In this topic, we study conservation efforts like Project Tiger, Project Elephant, Project Vulture, Project Snow Leopard, Project Hangul, Sea Turtle Project, One Horned Rhinoceros, Ganges Dolphin. In this topic, student must study project establishment dates, nature of project and animal which conserve. Environmental issues. The next topic is environmental issues are related to, it is related to anthropogenic factors that are in operation, and there has been a lot of debate and discussion about climate change. Whether in this section we should study climate change, global warming, greenhouse effect, greenhouse gases, types of greenhouse gases, carbon emissions, acid rain, ozone depletion, impact of climate change on India, agriculture, water stress, sea level rise, health and biodiversity. There is a list of responsibility on the developing and developed nation that how to reverse process of climate change and reduce the emission of gases. Following PPT or picture shows greenhouse and greenhouse phenomenon. Next topic is carbon sequestration, carbon sink, carbon credit and carbon tax. In this section, questions are based on definition and concept only. Like, what is meant by carbon sink, or give example of carbon sink, or give concept on carbon sequestration. Next topic, climate change organization. In this section, we should study mitigation measures taken at national and international level, like recent climate change summits held, objectives of the summits like UNFCCC, Kyoto Protocol, Bali Meet, Copenhagen Summit, Cancun Summit, Durban Summit, RED and RED Plus or IPCC, different convention and protocol establishment date and purpose are asked in examination, like Vienna Convention, Montreal Protocol, Stockholm Convention, Basel Convention, Bonn Convention, Barcelona Convention, Benzin Convention, Ramsar Convention, Nagoya Protocol and protocol like CITES. Next topic, acts and policies. In this section, we should study government effort to conserve environment through legal machinery, like different acts, policies and programs like Wildlife Protection Act 1972, Environmental Protection Act 1986, National Forest Policy 1988, Biological Diversity Act 2002, Coastal Regulation Zone 1, 2, 3, 4, National Green Tribunal, Scheduled Tribes and Other Forest Dwellers Act 2006, CAMPA, Social Forestry, Joint Forest Management, EcoMark, Mangrove for Future, National Ganga River Basin Authority. Dear student, we took a review on mains and prelim syllabus. After taking vast discussion with syllabus, let us take a look at previous year questions. Dear friends, previous year question, dear student, please try to give answer on previous year questions. First question, which of the following national park is unique in being a swamp with floating vegetation that supports a rich biodiversity? Option number 1, Bhitarkanika National Park, 2, Kebul Lamjo National Park, 3, Kewaldev Ghana National Park, 4, Sultanpur National Park. In this question, UPSC asks a swamp with floating vegetation national park, and option number 2, Kebul Lamjo National Park, is the right answer. Next question, what can be the impact of excessive inappropriate use of nitrogenous fertilizer in agriculture? First, proliferation of nitrogen fixing microorganism in soil can occur. Second, increase in the acidity of soil can take place. Third, leaching of nitrate to the groundwater can occur. Select the correct answer using the code given below. Number 1 option 1 and 3 only, 2, 2 only, 3, 2 and 3 only, 4, 1, 2, 3. Dear friends, when we use inappropriate nitrogenous fertilizer, there is no proliferation of nitrogen fixing microorganism. So option number 1 is cancelled. Second, increase in the acidity of soil can take place. Yes, increase in the acidity of soil takes place. Second is correct. Third, leaching of nitrate to the groundwater can occur. Yes, the water pollution, one of the cause of water pollution is leaching of nitrate to the groundwater. So 2 and 3 option is correct. Option number 3 is correct, 2 and 3 only. Next question. With reference to the International Union for Conservation of Nature and Natural Resources and the Convention of International Trade in Endangered Species of Wild Fauna and Flora sites, which of the following statement is correct? IUCN is an organ of the United Nations and site is an international agreement between government. IUCN runs thousands of field projects around the world to better management of natural environments. CITES is a legally binding on the state that have joined it, but this convention does not take the place of national laws. Select the correct answer using the code given below. 1 correct, 2 and 3 correct, 1 and 3 only, 1, 2, 3. Dear friends, IUCN is not a part of, you know, United Nations. So option number 1 is cancel. So A option cancel, C option cancel, and D option cancel. And the right answer is option number B, 2 and 3 only option is correct. Next one. With the reference to fly ash produced by the power plants using coal as a fuel, which of the following statement is correct? First, fly ash can be used in the production of bricks for building and construction. Second, fly ash can be used as a replacement for some of the Portland cement content of concrete. Third, fly ash is made up of silicon dioxide and calcium oxide only and does not contain any toxic elements. Dear friends, option number 1 is correct. Fly ash is used for production of bricks and construction. Option number 1 is correct. Second, fly ash is replacement for Portland cement. Yes, 10% fly ash is used in Portland cement. Option 1 and 2 is correct. Option number 3, fly ash is made up of silicon dioxide and calcium oxide only. No. And does not contain any toxic element. Yes, fly ash contains toxic element. So option number 3 is barred. Only option number 1 and 2 is correct. So right answer is option number 1, A option. Next question. With reference to biotoilets used by the Indian Railways, consider the following statement. The decomposition of human waste in the biotoilets is initiated by fungal inoculum. Second, ammonia and water vapors are the only products in this decomposition which are released into the atmosphere. Which of the statement given above is correct? The decomposition of human waste in biotoilets is initiated by fungal inoculum. No friend, dear friend, no, fungal inoculum not used. There use bacterial inoculum like a xerophile bacteria. So option number 1 is cancelled. Ammonia and water vapor are the only end products. No, there is other products is also produced. So here is answer is neither 1 nor 2. The next PPT shows UPSC mains question. UPSC paper number 4, general studies number 3, ask UPSC mains question. The UPSC mains question, let us take a review on UPSC mains question. First, access to affordable, reliable, sustainable and modern energy is the sine qua non to achieve a sustainable development goal. Comment on the progress made in India in this regard. Here we elaborate sustainable development goal in our mains paper. Second, what are the impediments disposing the huge quantities of discarded solid waste which are continuously being generated? How do we remove safely the toxic waste that have been accumulated in our habitable environment? Third question, coastal sand mining, whether illegal or illegal, poses one of the biggest threats to our environment. analyze the impact of sand mining along the Indian coast, citing specific examples. Fourth, what is wetland? Explain the Ramsar concept of wide use in the context of wetland conservation. Cite two examples of Ramsar sites from India. Fifth question, Sikkim is the first organic state in India. What are the ecological and economical benefits of organic state? Sixth question, how does biodiversity vary in India? How is the Biological Diversity Act 2002 helpful in conservation of flora and fauna? Dear friends, we took a small review on mains question. We would discuss all these topics in our foundation course. Thank you for watching my lecture, and please register our online UPSC course. Thank you, friends, and have a nice day.